So now that we understand how the FAT format works, let's consider its strengths and weaknesses. It is easy to create a new file, since we just need to adjust the directory table of the parent directory and set the busy bit in the FAT for the starting block. Growing a file is as easy as adjusting the next field of the FAT. Space usage is efficient too. If a block is free, then it can be used, and it doesn't matter whether the adjacent blocks are being used or not. This means that the system won't suffer from what is called external fragmentation. As for access, it will behave much like a linked list. It will be great for sequential access, as we quickly find and follow the links, but poor for random access, since we have to walk through half the links to get to the middle of the file, and all of the links to get to the end. This isn't as bad as it might seem at first, because we keep the FAT in memory, but it's still not ideal. Overall, then, FAT is a poor choice for situations where random access to large files is necessary. Hence, it has fallen out of favor. It is still a good choice for removable storage, however, where one is mostly just copying data from one machine to another, and hence only using sequential access. And its space efficiency makes it especially attractive.